Let's get it for Layla.
So elders agree.
7.7% of Nuu-chah-nulth are fluent speakers. I see some of those speakers here. All of those speakers are elderly. And linguists agree that within the next 10 years, 90% of the world's indigenous languages will be forever unspoken. So our older generations who are raised in educational institutions, we're subjected to ridicule and shaming and all manner of abuses within residential schools, which created a lot of social emotional barriers to becoming speakers of the language. There are a lot of our older generation who went through that, that can understand so much of our language, but there's a barrier there from all of the shaming and the ugliness that went on. So, to reconnect to our ancestors, their ways were kind, generous and giving and friendly. So if we want to try and look further back to our ancestors, we will need to look to our ancestors for direction. So in the past century and a half, Nuu-chah-nulth have been subject to widespread catastrophic disease such as smallpox, tuberculosis, moving because of economics, geographical shift and language and cultural loss because of the residential schools and colonial policies. And criminalization also of our livelihood, which is gathering foods. So now, as graduates, we have a dual role. We have a dual role to pursue knowledge through education and through our own ancestral roots. So I trace my own pursuit of indigenous language revitalization to a single incident on the beach in Hawaii. And I'd like to share a personal story here to connect to something that is integral to Nuu-chah-nulth ways of knowing and Nuu-chah-nulth worldview, something that should be recognized instead of shamed in schools and within our communities. That one day on the beach in Hawaii, a crab yelled at me, "Learn your language! Do whatever it takes!" And it was in that moment when I said, okay, I'll do it. And I didn't know how. And I hadn't considered it before that it was possible. And I see that as a pivotal moment in learning, a crucial moment in Nuu-chah-nulth ways of learning and knowing about this place in this world that we inhabit and that we steward. And so that's something that needs to be reintegrated into our educational systems and acknowledged as a valid tool for learning. Because in that moment, I actually felt, without any kind of prior expectation of this happening, what it feels like that the language is alive, just for that second. And that is a crucial part of education. That is something that our ancestors relied on in certain situations, to push them forward through the tough times, push them forward through negativity, through any kind of barriers that have gone up in their past. And reaching back to the ways that our ancestors really developed their knowledge systems and took care of this place that we call the Nuu-chah-nulth territory is going to be an integral part that I hope graduates, I know some people in this graduating class here are going to be contributing, it's going to be their life's work to be bringing back our ways and our cultural views and our language. And I think that there's some good work ahead that will help as Umbeek states to bring us into equity, to bring our knowledge systems up to a place of equity with Mamakwe knowledge systems in this country. The same colonial history that has silenced our languages and cultures in Canada has silenced and quieted many of our ancestral teachings. And it is the work of all of us, Nuu-chah-nulth, to restore those teachings back into daily life, especially when you're reaching an older age in your life. It becomes your job to speak, no matter feel like speaking in that way. It's our job, and we need to be training as adults who are aging to become those people who can, who have been close to the elders and who are able to share those teachings that are so important. So how can we move forward towards equity? Well, it starts with individuals, at the individual level. In order to recognize the value of Nuu-chah-nulth worldview, we need to name our children with Nuu-chah-nulth names. We need to remember those names, treat them with respect and care, that we are never going to forget them and never drag that name through the mud. We need to sing songs, and we need to keep creating songs. We need to hear stories from elders, we need to listen to what they have to tell us, and we need to create new stories, because we are a living Nuu-chah-nulth people. We're creating, we must continue to create in our way. We need to teach language to our children starting in the womb, and continue the efforts to teach our children to speak. Allow yourself time to listen to others, most importantly. Let us be the most precious gifts in the past several years, is to spend the time with those precious elders. I see Layla over there. She has taught us so much. So in order to receive ancestral teachings and trust your intuition and learn, we are required to look back to our ancestors for guidance and support, and in moments of weakness, look back to your ancestors to strengthen yourselves. So to the graduates, don't wait for permission to save your culture, to save your language. Don't wait for anybody to tell you it's okay for you to start now. Do whatever it takes. I want to sing on behalf of the post-secondary graduates a song of thankfulness, which it says, you have done a kind and generous thing, you chose education. My spirit is lifted. My spirit is raised.